Welcome student, today our topic is the different options for how to connect my device to the internet. So in which first we have to see the option one, access this device only on the home or business network. So this diagram, this is the schematic diagram or the sketch diagram which is showing on this this scenario of IoT device is configured as a servers, and the easiest way to assign a static IP, and this address is coded into this diagram. So when a client connect to the IoT device, it passes through the switch and out to the device it is connected to. So no routing is required here. Another option is device connect to a local or remote server. In this scenario, the IoT device initiate connection to the local or the remote server. So this could be using the HTTP REST POST or the configured the MQTT clients. It could also be custom connection method as long as it is initiated. The connection to the remote services, because the device is creating connection and it allows us to use the DHCP and the dynamic assigned IP addresses. So this diagram is showing here. In this, there are two of the devices that sends the HTTP REST POST to a server in the cloud. If the remote server accepts the connection and data, it will generally respond with the 200. Okay, then the client will then close the connections until the next port is set. So this is the way, the option two, where the devices connect to the local or the remote server. In option three, the access of device from the internet with the static public IP address. The world is running out of IPv4 IP address, and this means that ISP are pretty strict on giving out strict IP addresses. It's much easier for them to use a dynamic pool of the IP addresses to assign to their clients. But generally, home internet services are not available with the public IP. Static IP addresses. So however, we might be able to pay extra for this functionality, and some business accounts are available with static IP addresses. And the most common reason for wanting to static IP is for hosting an email server. So in this diagram, we could use the HTTP 1.127.48.156 or HTTP 1.127.48.156:491.55 to connect to the IoT server. And in the first URL, we do not specify the port number, so the browser will use the default port of 80, that is 80. Or in the second URL, we use the port that is 491.55. So by using a random private port number, we improve the security for our IoT server. And if someone does a port scan, they will always check port 80 as its default. So they might not bother scanning the private port numbers. And if you have the multiple IoT devices, you can set up port forwarding on the router to recognize the different port number. So this is the way to accessing the devices from the internet with the static public IP address. Now the last, that is the fourth options of access the devices from the internet with the dynamic public IP address. One of the most common way of dealing with the dynamic public WAN, wide area network IP addresses, and is a use of dynamic DNS services. So this DNS services, some of these services are free, most require a monthly payment, and most routers these days support the third party dynamic DNS services providers and we configure the router with the provider and username and password. Then we route. When the router detects the wide area network interfaces, IP addresses, changes is update the DDNS servers, services provided with the new IP details. So when we sign up with one of these providers, we provide a domain name and we would like to use it. In the example, the name of this using and this is a subdomain, that is dns.com. When we enter the tactico dysdn.com into the browser, and it will do a dsn lookup on the subdomain. So if it's valid domain, it will respond with IP addresses which just happens to be the public, that IP address to the home office router. So the office router will detect the data packets matches to records or records in the port forwarding table and pass the data onto the IoT devices using the static IP, that is 192.168.1.45. So the IoT device will respond with the appropriate HTML view in the internet client browsers. So these are all the four options for IP addressings in the IT. Now the last, that is the media access control, that is called the MAC, MSC. This is the sublayer. You can say the provide the addressing and the channel access control mechanism, and this enables the several terminal or network node to communicate in the network. So the MAC sublayer act as an interface between the logical link control, that is LLC, Ethernet sublayer and layer 1, that is the physical layer. The MAC sublayer emulates a full duplex logical communication channel in the multipoint network. So this channel may provide the unicast, multicast or the broadcast communication services, and the MAC sublayer uses the MAC protocol to prevent the collisions. So in layer 2, multiple devices on the same physical link can uniquely identify the other or the another at the data link layer by using the MAC addresses, and that are the assigned to all port on the switch. So a MAC algorithm accepts an input, a secret key and an arbitrary length message to be authenticated and output for MAC addresses. So this is the media access control mechanism, okay, for network to communicate in the networks. Thank you. Thank you to all of you.